Today, we're going to talk about what is the best broadhead to shoot, and we're starting right now. If you guys are new to the channel, please consider hitting that subscribe button. Also, click that bell icon so you guys never miss a video. What you guys can do is leave me a comment down below, let me know your thoughts, and let me know what kind of broadheads that you are currently shooting. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to make a short video, and I want to keep it simple. What is the best broadhead that you can possibly shoot for hunting deer, elk, any kind of animal that you want to hunt? What is the best broadhead? Well, it's the broadhead that works best for you. It's the broadhead that shoots straight with your setup. It's simple, guys. There's so much confusion and so much hype and so much... I've never seen people get so mad about a certain topic when it comes to hunting than it is with broadheads. Guys, keep it simple. I'm telling you right now, you can kill a deer with a field tip. It's all in shot placement, okay? It all boils down to shot placement. I've shot fixed blades, every kind of mechanical you can think of, every kind of fixed blade broadhead, they all kill deer. And the first time you lose a deer with a broadhead, immediately that person blames that broadhead. Well, I can almost guarantee you, it had nothing to do with your broadhead. It boils down to shot placement and the recovery of that animal. Sometimes you single lung that deer could run 400, 500, 600 yards, and if you don't wait long enough and you push that animal, you're not gonna find them. It boils down to shot placement and the recovery. Now, I'm not promoting a certain broadhead here. I'm explaining to you guys what I shoot and what is comfortable in my, or what shoots straight in my setup. When you find a broadhead, the main thing that I look for is straightness of that broadhead. So you guys can purchase an arrow spinner. I check all my arrows like this. I check all my broadheads. You can check broadhead wobble. You can see if your arrow is bent. You can check knock wobble and things like that. If that broadhead is straight, then you're good to go. If the manufacturing of that broadhead is straight, you'll be able to tell from the arrow spinner. And I'll spin all my arrows. I'll spin the broadhead. Next thing you want to do is obviously you want to shoot it. You want to see where that broadhead's hitting. See if it shoots like your field tip. If it shoots like your field tip, that's what you want to use. Now, I've shot Rage. I've shot, I've shot every kind of broadhead you can think of. I used to shoot muzzies for years, killed dozens of deer with muzzies. Currently, haven't killed a deer. I haven't even hunted with these yet. But this is a three-blade Swagger. I've shot, multiple deer, probably over a dozen deer with a two-blade Swagger. They work perfectly fine. They shoot straight with my setup. Now, any mechanical, I'm sure there are issues where a mechanical didn't open and all this other stuff, but it is extremely rare. The broadheads that are produced today, they all work. They all will kill a deer if the animal is shot right, guys. Stop the arguments over broadheads. Pick a broadhead that you feel comfortable with. So if you want to shoot a Rage, if long as that Rage shoots straight like your field tips, okay, it'll kill a deer. It will kill a deer if you hit it in the perfect place. You know, this Swagger, it's a three-blade Swagger. I haven't shot him yet, but I guarantee you it'll kill a deer. I guarantee it. You can kill a deer with field tips. So guys, stop all the confusion when it comes to broadheads. Calm down about it, relax, buy a broadhead that maybe looks cool to you, or if you're into testing them and you want to see which one shoots straight, buy a few of them. Get out there, shoot them. As long as they're shooting straight, I promise you, it will kill a deer. Focus more on shot placement. Shot placement is key. Like I said, if you single lung that deer, that animal is going to run, you know, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700 yards, especially if you're pushing that animal, and you're not going to find it. You know, give that animal time. I always wait a minimum of 30 minutes. I'll go down, check my arrow, see what that arrow looks like. Maybe I might track it for maybe 10, 20, 30 yards. And so I start seeing blood. I'll gather some opinions about the blood trail, what the blood looks like, if there's bubbles in it, if it's dark, if it's light colored. And then I'll assess the situation at that time. And I might back out. I might come back, you know, 3-4 hours later or something like that. If that deer is quartered away from you, you always, depending how quartered it is, but 90% of the time, if that deer is quartered away, you want to shoot that, you want to put your shot behind that last rib, because if you don't, that arrow can deflect and it'll lodge up in that shoulder and you're not going to find that animal. So you always want to shoot, if that deer is quartered away, behind that last rib, and that's going to help you out with quartered away shots. Obviously, if that deer, an optimal 25-30 yard bow shot is a broadside shot, you double lung that animal, heart shot, that deer is done. If you double lung a deer, it's dead within 100 yards. If you heart shot it, it's dead within 50 to 100 yards, you know what I mean? I shot a deer last year, quartered away, shot it right behind that last rib, it ran 50 yards and piled up and it was done. Calm down, guys. Just find a broadhead that shoots straight for you, and I promise you, it will kill deer.